Hello, 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 and welcome back to Hunter Tuned. Today we are messing with the transmission for the Chevstang, and we're having some issues. So I guess I'm kind of maybe seeing what you guys think of this. I'm going to be talking with Dusty Bradford and my transmission rebuilder today, but we ended up going to pick up the transmission. He actually had a case and got everything situated, so we have a new case, new everything really. So anyways, we've been messing with this thing for a little while, and we got the CSI SFI certified bell housing shroud on this thing, and I tapped two of the bell housing bolts that I don't use, and we ran some bolts in through the shield here, and this thing's rock solid. The shield is not going anywhere, and the bolts do not protrude on the motor side of the transmission here, so that way I can run these bolts in, got them tight so the shield is tight, and then I'm going to run the remaining four bolts to the motor. So anyways, we have had some struggles. We got the shield on, no problem. We swapped over the new transmission fittings into this thing. We got the transmission trans brake solenoid put in. We needed a new valve and spring for the trans brake, because when the transmission broke in the car, it flung the spring and the valve out of the valve body for the trans brake, and the solenoid was just dangling. So I verified the solenoid was good. We got the solenoid installed. I'll show you that stuff here. So we have the solenoid is installed. Everything is good there. We got the valve and spring inside behind the solenoid. And yeah, so everything is looking good there. We went to go put the converter on, and we got the car jacked up in the air, obviously. So we went to go put the converter back in. I verified, I talked to the transmission guy and Dusty, and they both said, just make sure that the snout is not cracked. So like the snout of the transmission is going to be pretty much, this is not the PTC converter, but the snout is the silver piece here. And just check on the inside there to make sure that, you know, it didn't crack or there wasn't any like damage inside of there. So I verified that, and that was all good to go. So the next step to check the converter was take a screwdriver on the inside and make sure everything spins freely. You know, the stator and the whatever other part is in there. And I verified that they spin both, you know, fans inside the converter spin very freely. It spins great. Yeah, so anyways, we went to go put the converter onto the transmission, and it went on super hard. We, you know, normally you get the three clicks when you put the converter into the transmission. First is the input shaft, then the pump gear, and the pump splines. So this appears to be my old pump. He said he went through everything. He had to replace a couple things in the transmission to make it operable again. Obviously it needed a new output shaft and all that kind of stuff, new case. Clutches looked all right and stuff, he said. So anyways, we went to put the pump on, or the converter, sorry, long day. And the converter just went on very tight, and it was spinning really tight. So I'm like, man, maybe the converter is damaged. I have no idea. So I brought out old trusty Summit fucking torque converter right here, because that thing had really no issues, you know, spinning on the trans, and it didn't have any issues really when I pulled it off. So I tried that converter, same thing. It spun really tight, and it, you know, it just didn't seat very easily. So what I'm saying when it spins tight is when the converter is sitting on the front of the transmission here, to go spin it clockwise or counterclockwise, it took two hands to be able to like muscle it over to get it to spin. Normally, you know, the converters, you can flick them with your pinky and they just, you know, wing around, no problem. We did put fluid in the converter, and we tried it dry, we tried it with fluid. It still is a little bit tough. So I don't know if maybe the pump shaft is bent, or if the pump inside the pump something is bad. I don't know if you guys have ever ran into this issue before, but maybe just seeing what people think, because I have no idea what's going on. Like I said, I don't think the converter is hurt. I think maybe this pump is bad or something. I don't know if maybe I can just put it together and it'll kind of work itself free. I was also thinking that since the transmission's brand new again, he said he put new pump gears in and he put new pump bushings in and all that kind of stuff, that maybe the bushing is just a little bit tight and it needs to kind of work itself out. But we literally couldn't We got the converter fully seated finally. Christian actually tipped the transmission straight up and down 12 o'clock, and I was pushing on it really hard as I was spinning to get the converter to seat. And then once the converter was seated, it was tough to spin the converter. Like I said, I don't know if that's a cause for concern or not, but I'm just maybe reaching out to you guys to see what you think. And the other last thing is the converter was tough to spin clockwise, and it was also tough to pull it out of the transmission. Like normally when you pull the converter out, they kind of just slide right up. Like, you know, when you got to mate it to the flex plate, when you got to mate the converter to the flex plate, it should slide easily up to the flex plate where it needs to be. And this setup just is really tight. Like, it's really hard to pull it out of the transmission. It actually took us a lot of muscle to get the converter back out of the transmission. So I don't know, maybe it's okay, maybe it's not. Maybe I just need to run it. I don't know. Maybe I got to get a pump. I have no idea, but yeah. So anyways, we got everything else done. We got the transmission temperature sensor wire hooked up behind the CSI shield here. We got the mount, the transmission mount, and everything off of the old setup. We got that done. Check out the case, guys. This is the old one. This is the old case. Pretty freaking gnarly. So yeah, I don't know. What do you guys think? Leave it down in the comments. Let me know. I figured I'd give you guys some sort of video. Better than nothing. I didn't really film a whole lot of stuff today. But yeah, so anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Let me know what you guys think down in the comments. And see you later. Have a great night and a better tomorrow.